I don't think we should disturb Jormungandr without some reason.
So when we get to the boat, we can either look for that special chisel now, or go exploring for a little while. I'm happy with whatever you want to do. I can read what this says now, but it's a name. Air! Whoa! The name made it light up!
It's the name of one of the Valkyries. That's quite curious.
Nightmares! Ugh! What awful pests!
Mommy, look out!
Boy, over here.
Sir. Hey, it's another treasure map.
Which way to the chisel?
Keep rowing towards the statues of the oarsmen, then thread past between them.
You never did tell me why Freya spit in your face.
Well, she blames me in large measure for her present circumstances, and not totally without reason. It all goes back to the long war between the Aesir and Vanir. Prior to that, wars for the Aesir were easily won, but the Vanir had proved their equal and exacted devastating damage. Both sides suffered tremendous losses, and for many of us, quite frankly, war was simply no fun anymore, but a rather senseless waste of precious life. Wouldn't you agree, brother? Precisely. Enough was enough. And at last, Odin's most brilliant advisor became determined to find a more enlightened path. He set about to broker a peace between the gods.
Enough. No stories. Not while on foot. Our focus is the road.
Completely understand. I'll finish later, lad.
In the middle of a story before. So, how did this advisor of Odin's try to end the long war?
Took some convincing, but ultimately Odin was persuaded to marry his deadliest enemy, a certain Vanir goddess, legendary not only for her fertile beauty, but her genius at the very Vanir magic that Odin had long aspired to master.
Freya married Odin?
Ulfric.
Or I can just tell you the story later.
You were taken from this realm too early.
The special chisel is ahead, past this gate.
Thank you.
You who walks among the living. My beloved Gulvig calls to me. She yearns for peace.
You want us to collect her bones?
Gulvig Sather Man.
Really?
Boy.
I can smell your grief, child.
Boy, we are leaving.
They've taken three of sweet Gulvig's bones and spread them across the lake. Bring me her bones, child. Gulvig will reward you.
Father, maybe we should look for those bones.
Why?
Didn't you hear him? We could talk to Mom again. If we keep an eye out...
This chisel we seek. What is it?
I'm glad you asked, actually. I have just the story for you. There was a giant once named Famur. A very giant giant. Who, despite his mountainous size, was without question the greatest stonemason this world had ever seen. Proud Famur hoped to one day pass his vast knowledge onto his son. But young Hrimthur had the heart of a warrior. Perhaps the father had too much fear in him, or the son too little. Either way, the quarrel of the air spiraled out of control, and the overworked stonemason, bonk, struck his son. Hrimthur ran off into the night. Feeling shame and regret, Famur chased after his son. But in his emotional state, soon found himself wandering Midgard, lost and alone. Sadly, he caught the eye of the one person he didn't want to meet alone that night, so far from home. Thor.
And what happened next?
You'll see.
Thor killed him. Oh no. He fell in the village?
Aye. When Famur fell, he crushed a charming place famed for worshipping the Vanir god Njord. Thor always took credit for planning that one. The truth is, the sweaty ball bag just got lucky.
Dangerous beast. We will take him down together. Ready yourself, boy.
Need more time.
Tip of one, yes. A very, very giant. Brother, looks like that crystal's brimming again. Trick, lad.
Thanks. His idea. What happened to the survivors?
Oh, Thamur was a frost giant. When he died, his final breath froze everything.
This is locked up good.
Follow me, Atreus.
On my way!
Find the tip of that chisel. That's the magic we need.
Hostiles up ahead. Just give the word. I'm ready!
Thank you.
Hey, pardon the world of pizza. That's Andy. I like crystal base, but where's the crystal?
Read it.
To Njord, we offer back the seas back.
Ah, yes. It was believed that Njord calmed the winds and seas for the fishermen. For that, they loved and worshipped him here.
Thank you.
How are we getting down there?
I have a plan.
You do?
Do not act so surprised.
Oh, no offense, brother, but I don't even think Thor with Mjolnir in hand could get through that much ice.
Then Thor is a fool.
This should be entertaining.
Boy.
Right.
Wow, that was something, that fight. Here, catch.
Well, that was a waste of a perfectly good apple.
How were you not seen? There is nowhere here to hide.
Oh, that. It's a little trick my people can pull. A special way of not being seen.
You can be invisible?
More like I can step into the realm between realms. And your mind doesn't understand what it's seeing, so it sees nothing at all. That's how we avoid ever having to actually use the weapons we craft. It doesn't seem to work on dragons, though.
Your brother wanted to know if you're getting enough to eat. I guess I could tell him you are.
Brock was asking about me?
Was there mead on his breath?
You let him touch this again. Come on, then.
So that's how Brock was in the temple right after the water drop. He stepped between realms.
Okay, now, shush. I need complete silence for this. There you go.
So, what can I do for you two? And what can I do for you? To you.